According to the known laws of physics, my favorite food, tacos, shouldn't exist. But no, physics isn't specifically against these tortilla treats. Neither you nor I should exist either. In fact, all of the matter, all of the stuff in our universe shouldn't exist. Fortunately, my, and hopefully by now your, favorite little particle, the neutrino, just might be a clue to figuring out why it does. Today, we're discussing what teeny tiny neutrinos have to do with the existence of tacos and everything else in the universe. Wait a second, hold on, what is this? What are you doing? I'm hosting this video about matter and antimatter. No, that's my job. Oh, come on, you've done all of the videos. It's my turn to host.
Right, because it's my video series.
And hey, that's my taco. Now look what you've done. We've annihilated each other.
Kirsty, sorry I'm late. I hope I haven't missed anything important. Kirsty, are you there? Oh, look, tacos. Okay. Well, I'll go ahead as we planned. To understand why the universe exists, we have to understand the difference between matter and antimatter. A particle and its antiparticle have the same mass, but all of their other quantum mechanical properties are reversed. For example, electrons are negatively charged, and positrons are positively charged. Properties like spin and momentum will also be the opposite of its partner particles. Because of this, if a particle and antiparticle meet each other, they annihilate. They can turn into photons or other particles, as allowed by their energies and by quantum mechanics. We can calculate this using the famous E equals mc squared. This set us up for possibly the biggest mystery of the universe itself. We think that the Big Bang should have created equal amounts of matter and antimatter, which should have all annihilated each other, leaving the universe full of energy and empty of matter and antimatter. But if you're watching this video, well, you exist, so clearly that hasn't happened.
I'm back. Sorry I left you hanging, Pedro. I was dealing with anti-me. You know how it is. You didn't talk about neutrinos without me, did you?
Oh no, I didn't. I was just explaining how the universe started with slightly more matter than antimatter.
Perfect. Yes, there was probably only one extra matter particle per million particle-antiparticle pairs. But over time, it added up to, well, everything. Atoms, galaxies, you, me, tacos. It seems that this universe likes matter more than antimatter. Why? Scientists are still searching for an exact answer, but it has something to do with a wrinkle in the fundamental symmetry of the universe. Symmetry is seen almost everywhere in the physics world, but something in the beginning of the universe tipped the scales towards matter. The more hints of asymmetry physicists can find at the most fundamental levels, the more clues we have about why there's more matter than antimatter.
There's a rule in physics called CP symmetry that essentially means if every particle in the universe was replaced with its antiparticle and reflected in a mirror, all of the laws of physics would still work exactly the same. We want to find examples of that symmetry being broken by finding particles and antiparticles that don't behave quite the same.
And this is where neutrinos finally come into the picture. Thanks, Pedro. I'll take it from here. We've discussed how neutrinos can change what flavor they appear as, just like this ball can rotate from red to blue to yellow. Antineutrinos also change flavors. If neutrinos obey the symmetry rules, then antineutrinos should change in the exact same way. But current experiments have seen some hints that neutrinos and antineutrinos might flavor shift differently, which is really exciting. It could be another hint towards whatever imbalance in the early universe led to all the matter you see around you today, including your lunch. While our current results are encouraging, they don't provide quite enough data for scientists to say for certain that neutrinos are breaking the symmetry rules. That means we need more neutrinos, a lot more neutrinos. And that's why I'm working on the Deep Underground Neutrino Experiment, which will see incredible numbers of neutrinos, thanks to huge detectors and an intense new particle beam. The neutrinos and antineutrinos created at Fermilab will be mostly muon flavor. Once they've made their 800-mile journey to the June detectors in South Dakota, lots of them will have oscillated and will interact as the electron flavor. If June measures different numbers of electron neutrinos and antineutrinos than CP symmetry predicts, that could be evidence that neutrinos and antineutrinos follow different rules of physics. And that could point scientists towards an explanation for the origin of tachos, I mean, the universe. What's your guess? Do you think neutrinos will break symmetry rules? Let us know in the comments. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for more quality neutrino content. Fun fact, scientists have already measured a difference between matter and antimatter in quarks. Kaons and b-mesons, which are made up of quarks and antiquarks, decay in a way that slightly breaks CP symmetry. But the matter-antimatter difference here is far too small to account for all the matter we see around us today. Theory suggests that neutrinos could violate CP 1,000 times more than quarks. So, the search for more symmetry-breaking neutrinos continues. Wait, where did my taco go? Not touching you, not touching you, not touching you. Don't do it.